connect to us. So here is the solution of your test which was given to you on 25th of this month. So first question was, how many natural numbers lie between squares of the following natural numbers, that is 25 and 26. So this question was based upon the property that I have written here. We know that between n square and n plus 1 square. Question is, how many natural numbers lie between squares of the following natural numbers? That is, the consecutive numbers are there. If one is n, then another is n plus 1 and their squares. So one property out of those 20 properties, you just can go through those 20 properties I have explained to you to find the numbers between the squares of two consecutive numbers. There are 2n non-perfect square numbers. This property we have to apply here in this question number 1. So here n is given equal to 25 because your first number is 25 and second is 25 plus 1 is 26. So there are 2n non-perfect squares between the squares of two consecutive numbers. So 1 mark is for writing this property in support of your answer. And your n is equal to 25, so therefore the number between 25 square and 26 square are 2 into 25, 2n. So I said n is equal to 25. So 2n means 2 into n. N is 25, so 2 into 25 is equal to 50. So 50 natural numbers will be lying between the square of 25 and 26. So 1 mark for this calculation and 1 mark for this. The question was of 2 marks. Then your second question was, you have to find the square of 605 and 999 by using the suitable identities. Already I have allotted these questions in your assignments. So one, you have to split nearest zeros, ending zeros in 605 or 600. So you can split it in form of 600 plus 5. So that is a plus b whole square, a square plus b square plus 2ab. Apply in place of a and b, you have to put 605 and then check the calculation, do these additions carefully and multiplication and check the answer. That is 366,025 for the first part, and in second it is closest to 1000, so better to split in terms of 1000 minus 1 whole square. So again a square plus b square, but now here it is of minus sign, so minus 2ab. So then your answer will be 998,001. So please check the calculation. Both the parts were of 1.5, 1.5. If the all calculations are correct, then full 1.5. If the identity you have written correctly, then half mark for each identity and 1 mark for calculation. In that way, this question gets 3 marks. Then your third question was, find the smallest number by which 9,408 must be divided so that it becomes a perfect square. So also find the square root of perfect square, so obtained. So that also was explained to you in case of multiplication or division. What you need to do is, you have to find the prime factors. So if you go for the prime factors of this 9,408, somewhere you will be getting 2 into 2 in pair, 2 into 2 another pair, 2 into 2 the third pair, 3 is alone there, and 7 into 7 is the one pair. Kindly check. If you have obtained all these factors, this question is of 4 marks. So 2 marks are reserved for this correct factorization. Please make a note of that. So 2 marks are there for this step, and you are finding the number alone is there 3. So if whole of this result I will divide by 3, what happens? 3 will go off and I will be left with this pair, and this pair, and hence the resulting number will be a perfect square because now no alone number will be there. So I need to divide it by 3. So 2 marks for this part, and when you will divide it by 3, then the remaining is itself a perfect square. And what is that? 1, 2 for this pair, you will write there. 1, 2 for this pair, 1, 2 for this pair. No 3 is there now because I have divided by 3. So 1, 7 for this pair. And check this, 2 into 2 into 2, 8. 8 sevens are 56. So 56 will be the square root of the resulting number, which will be a perfect square. So that is 2 marks for this part. So this question was of 4 marks divided in 2 parts. So please check the prime factors. Need to divide by 3 and then remove one number from these pairs you can pick and multiply that. So 56 will be the square root of the number which we will be getting after dividing by 3. So this is third question. Then fourth was, you are supposed to find the square root of your this 4937284 by division method. So procedure was explained to you. Make the pairs from left to right. One pair, two pair, three pair, four is alone. So two twos are four. Read the tables in square. Remainder is zero. Next pair 93. Double of two is four. Then here 93. So 42 twos are. Again this is 84. So take the remainder. That is 9. Next pair is of 72. Copy that pair there. 972. Double of 22 will become 44. And then again 44 staple up to 97. You put here 2 again. 884 will be there. Check the remainder. Now the remainder is equal to what here? That is again 88 somewhere you are getting. And last pair is of 84. So again now the double of 222 will become 444. And you know at the last there is 4. So if it is a perfect square, either I have to multiply by 4 or by 8. 2 2's are 4 or 8 8's are 64. So I will multiply by 2. So I will be getting 8 8 8 4. Remainder is 0. Hence it is a perfect square. The result of this number is 2222. That will be the square root of this number. So check your steps. This was of 3 marks. If everything is correct, then only you have to give 3 marks. If any mistake is there, then no marks can be given in that. No step marking can be done for this. Then last question number 5 was, find the least number which must be added to this 3,6452 so that it is a perfect square. So now what happens? I have explained that question in two ways to you. Either what must be added to this number so that it becomes a perfect square. This was the another way to ask same question. So I explained you have to go one step forward. So that's why I have solve this in two ways to you. One is the normal way what we are following. Make the pairs, find the square root. So usually we are going in last less than that of 3952. So that is the way you are following. So you will be getting 553, but it is not a perfect square. To make it a perfect square, you have to follow this. Need not to show this just to make you people understand I have done this. What you have to do, you have not to take 3309. Go one step next. So it was at 3, so you try at 4. So when 4 will be there, you will try that will be 4416. What I mean to say is, usually we are taking less than that of this. But in this case, then you have to add some number to this number to make it a perfect square. You have to go to the next. Here it was with 3, so you have to multiply it by 4. And then, usually we are subtracting this number from this number. So here you have to subtract this number from this number. That is 4416 is there. From 4416 you have to subtract 3952. And remainder whatever will be there. That is 464. You add 464 to this number and find the square root. That will be a perfect square. So this question again was of 3 marks. So full 3 or 0 that you have to see. But if you have find the square root correctly, you can give 2 marks for that. If last step somewhere you are missing, so 1 mark you can reduce for that. So in that way you can do the evaluation of this test. I hope all the 5 questions are now clear to you. Then yesterday I have given you the properties of those cubes. Some queries were there, whether we have to write. The properties are already there in your textbook. But what you can do is, if you have a time, you can write the properties better from the revision point of view and start at least with question number 1, 2 and 3 of exercise 7.1, because tomorrow I will be coming with that. Thank you. Have a nice day.